Hello everyone, hope all of you guys are doing pretty well. So today's topic is entitlement list and catalog synchronization schedulers. So today we are going to discuss about the architecture of both of these two schedulers. As we already aware that catalog sync and entitlement list, these two schedulers comes out of the box once you install Oracle Identity Manager. So let's see or let's understand the architecture of both the schedulers. So let's consider a scenario. Now let's say this is my OUD, that is a LDAP server. Now I have integrated this OUD server with my OIM. Now for integration, we need to install the OID connector or OUD connector. So I did all the things, and once you install the connector, there are lots of artifacts which gets automatically stored or gets created inside your Oracle Identity Manager. The artifacts include process definition, resource object, process form, lookups. There are some schedule job and many more. So these artifacts get automatically created inside OIM once you are going to install the OUD connector. Now let's say in my OUD connector, there are four different groups defined. Let's say the first group is CN equal to admin. The second group is CN equal to demo access. The third group is CN equal to something XYG, and the fourth thing CN equal to, let's say, read access. Now these are the four different groups which are defined in my Oracle Unified Directory. Now once you install the connector, the first task is that why we are using the OIM. We are using the OIM so that end user will come here. They will open the self-service console and they can request for the access. Request for access to certain entitlements which are already there in the target system. Now let's say these are the four things. So we need to bring all those groups inside my OIM so that the individuals will be able to see those things in their catalog, and based on their requirement, they are going to raise the request for those items. So actually this complete logic is very much similar with our real life example. For example, let's say this is a organization. Let's say there is a online store called Amazon.in. Now a new seller wants to sell his product inside Amazon. So what he did, the new product or the new seller wants to sell some new deodorants, some new perfumes. So the seller wants to sell this product in Amazon. So what he did, he talked with Amazon. There was a negotiation done. Now once you do all the things, these two deodorants, the sale Amazon needs to load in his catalog. So Amazon loaded these two deodorants in his catalog. Now until unless this thing was not loaded in catalog, the end user was not able to request or not able to buy or purchase these two items inside Amazon. So this loading we refer, this is very similar with our OIM and OUD integration. So OUD is my seller who wants to sell certain access and all, which you need to onboard into your Amazon.com. The same thing as we did in real life, the same thing the we are doing in the digital life of Oracle Identity Manager. Now, once you load all these things, how the complete flow will go? This particular person or customer wants to buy a deo, he will add to cart deo, selecting the deo and going to add to cart. Now, once you add to cart, once you click on buy now, what Amazon will do? Amazon will ask you for the payment method. Amazon will ask you for the payment. Now, Once you do the payment, the item will be shipped. Shipped to your preferred location. Right? To your location. Now, if I am going to map all those things with OIM, this DO is either an application instance or entitlement. And this complete thing we are doing in the catalog of OIM. Now, when you click on buy now, it is similar with the request, submit request. Once you click on the payment, here OIM is going to trigger the approval policy based on the request you have, based on the item you have selected, approval policy. Now, once the approval will be done, the request will be granted to you, right? The same thing we are doing in real life world also. The terminologies are a bit different, but both of them are exactly the same thing. Now, once the seller wants to sell this product in OIM, we need to bring or load these items like OUD, these four items into my OIM. Now, there are several lookups which are defined based on the target type. Once you install this, the lookup, the schedule jobs, all will be defined. Now, there is a schedule job, something called LDAP connector, group lookup reconciliation, group lookup reconciliation. Now, what this group lookup reconciliation will do? This group lookup reconciliation is going to see in your OUD or the LDAP server, and it will bring all the groups into the OIM. So it is simply pulling the data from OIM to from OUD to OIM. Now, once you run this lookup, it is going to save all those data in a lookup which you are going to set in this particular part. In this lookup area, in this schedulers, you will get the target lookup name where all these changes are going to be modified. Now, once this lookup are getting populated, now let's say this is your target, as we talk about LDAP or OUD. Or OUD, you bring all those things from OUD using the lookup reconciliation, group lookup reconciliation, and save all these things into a place in OIM which we refer to as the lookup. Here code decode and the entries are written over here. Now this particular entry is going to be act as an input for my entitlement list scheduler. Entitlement list scheduler. This lookup or the group lookups are going to act as an input for this scheduler. Now, once this scheduler will run, it is going to look into all the lookups which are defined for various target system and been used for the entitlement. So it will look into that and it will update a table called ENT list. Once this table is updated, there is a thing called, we are also going to follow a step. We are going to follow some steps in order to bring those things into catalog. Then we run catalog sync. But why we run the catalog sync, most of you don't know. What this catalog sync will do, it is going to take the input from the ENT list table and it is going to bring all those things into the catalog table. Now from the catalog tables, the end users are seeing the things. So this is the complete architecture. First, we are bringing the things to lookup. Now from lookup, the entitlement scheduler will bring the things into ENT list table. From ENT list tables, the catalog sync table will bring the things into the catalog table. So this is the entire flow. Now let's go into the database tables and let's create a thing and then we'll going to see. Now first we talk about this particular area, right? So first consider this part. OUD. Let me open my system. Let me log into the self-service console. Now click on the schedulers. As we talk about, there are lots of schedulers comes out of the box once you install the connectors as a deployed as an artifact. Now these are all the schedulers comes when I integrate or when I install the OUD connector inside OIM. Now there is something called group lookup reconciliation. As you can see, group lookup reconciliation. Now if you see this particular scheduler, you will be able to see the lookup name. Means this particular lookup is going to be modified or going to be updated whenever this scheduler is going to be run. Let me copy this name and let me search this lookup in the, as you can see, I have already searched the same thing in my lookup and it contains right now three different values, the code and the decode part. Okay, now let me create a new group inside the target system. So this is my OUD. Now let me create a new group. Now I'm going to create a new entry, same as the same one, demo access, or I am going to give ENT list demo. ENT list demo, I have given the name. Click on next, click on finish. Now the group has been created. Now as you can see, right now we have only three entry. Let me refresh it, only three entry. Now I am going to run the scheduler for me. How the scheduler is going? We are giving the filter as null. It means every time it is going to reconcile all the groups from the Oracle Unified Directory. As you can see, it is going to look into the entire directory and it will show, it will search for the object type equal to group. Object type equal to group. It is going to search for all the objects which are of the group type and it is going to reconcile all those things into your Oracle Identity Manager and it will update this particular lookup based on the reconciliation. Now let me run this scheduler. It ran successfully. Let me refresh it again. As you can see, there is a new group also came here with the entitlement list demo. Now let me search that whether I am able to find this particular group in my catalog as of now or not. Let me request for access, request for self. Let me search for the ENT list demo has been already came here. How it came here? It came here because if you see my these two schedulers which I was talking about, that is the ENT list and the catalog sync. Let me, this scheduler was run during, the time is 3:39:41. Let me search for the ENT list scheduler. Let me check when this scheduler was run. This scheduler was running at the same time, right? If you see 3:39, this, because this scheduler is already set in the periodic mode. Okay, this scheduler already run in the periodic interval. So right now it just now ran and it bring all the details to my ENT list table. Now once the details will be came to the ENT list table, as you can see the catalog sync, it also ran at the same time. If you see 10:39, 3:39, 41, all the things ran in the same time. That's why it got updated. Now let me do one thing. It has, now you are able to see the things in the catalog, right? And you are now aware that how the things are going to be work. Now let me just tweak into the system. What tweak I am going to apply? That this particular, where is the, this was the entitlement which I have created over there, and if you go into the details you will be able to see the same name, ENT list demo. Now I am going to delete the things from the table. Let me select it. Let me delete this entry. Now how to delete? Delete entry. Click on delete. I have deleted the thing. Now let me run the group lookup reconciliation once again. As you can see in the table, we have four entries. Okay. Now I am going to run the things once again. This was the lookup. Run now. It ran successfully. Let me refresh this part. It again come back to 3. Means this lookup is actually getting overwritten each and every time, or it is getting automatically modified whenever you are going to bring the data from the target system. It is syncing with the target, and if there is any entry which is no more exists in the target system, it is removing from this lookup. Now as we talk about that, this lookup is going to be act as an input for my entitlement list scheduler. So let's see whether we are able to view this particular group in my OIM self-service or not. Let me close it. Let me search it once again. Let me select for the entitlement. We are not able to see this thing, right? Entitlement demo, we are not able to see. Now what are all the changes we went through on? The changes which happened, let me open the database. Now this is the ENT list is a table which is associated with entitlement list scheduler. Let me open the ENT list table itself. Now this is the table. Now this was the scheduler which we, this was the entitlement which we have created earlier. Now there is a column called ENT valid. ENT valid column is going to take care of the thing is that whether the entry is still there in lookup or not. Right now this entry is not there in the lookup, so this thing become invalid. That's why the value became 0. If this particular entry was present in the lookup, the value should be 1. If it is not there, it should be 0. Means this entitlement is no more valid in my target system. That's why it gets automatically gets to 0. Now let me open the catalog sync. Now for catalog sync, this table is going to be act as an input. Now this was the name of the ENT list demo. If you see the entity name is same, let me the same ENT list demo. Now there are two fields, is requestable and is deleted. Is requestable and is deleted. Now if you see, this particular entry is set as is deleted one. It means that this particular entry is no more valid in the ENT list table. That's why the catalog automatically set the value as deleted as 1. It means the value has been deleted in the target system. So in this way, the complete architecture flows. So that's it from my end for this particular session. I hope you learned something from this session. Just want to give you a small information that if you are interested in getting, or if you all want to learn Oracle Identity Manager, then I have already started my own batch. The batch has already been started. So if you want to join, you can ping me in my WhatsApp number, that is this, for any further details regarding the course and all. So that's it. Thank you and have a great day. Bye-bye.